Hello everyone. So we have a very renowned doctor, Dr. Sanjeev Ahuja, with us today. He's a pediatric specialist, and he's associated with Hiranandani Hospital for more than 15 years.
Yes.
So welcome to the show, Dr. Ahuja.
Yeah.
So Dr. Ahuja, what was it led to the become a pediatric person, and tell us about your journey from school
right.
to your career in
medicine. Well, I have actually always been in Mumbai. I was born and brought up in Mumbai.
Right.
Both my parents are doctors. My grandfather, my father's father, was also a doctor. So he in fact became a doctor in the pre-independence era.
Mm-hmm.
Most of my uncles, my father's brothers, are also either doctors or dentists. So in the family, right from the beginning,
right.
It's a family which, you know, usually almost everyone beyond, you know, their, you know, usual career, it's that somebody from the medical or paramedical field. So all along when I was studying, I had the in the back of my mind that I also probably would become a doctor. When we give our 12th standard exam, honestly, we are just about 17 years old. We're not very sure what we want to do in life. So I was frankly at that point of time thinking of taking up engineering. I was a science student, so definitely wanted to do something related to science. And my father told me something which I still remember, that if you want to do a profession where you don't have to depend on anybody else, where you can at least survive on your own merit, then do become a doctor. Because if you take up some other field, you may have to depend completely on a job on somebody else's doing. But when you're a doctor, he had said ke tum at least bhookha nahi maroge.
Right.
So then, and I was a good student right from my school days. In my school, which is St. Joseph's High School at Colaba, I was the first person in that school to achieve a percentage of 90.14 in SSC. Now, so, you know, students get 98 and 99% in their 10th standard, but at that time, this was a very good score. It was the highest score that anyone had got in that school ever.
True.
I got into Jai Hind College, did my 11th, 12th from there, had good marks in the 12th. So then the natural thing was that I took up medicine. I did my MBBS training from SETH GS Medical College, which is in Mumbai Parel, along which is attached to KEM Hospital. It's one of the best institutes in Maharashtra and Asia for doing your medical education. After passing my final MBBS, I had a choice of taking up either general medicine or pediatrics, orthopedics, surgery. But I was always inclined to taking a non-surgical branch, and I felt that I should. I thought at that point of time, and I hope I've been correct, that I would be a good pediatrician. So basically, it's a physician for children. It's a medical branch where we are catering to the health needs of babies right from the time they are born till they are about 12 years of age.
Right.
So it's an age where there's a very rapid growth development. There is a physical growth, a lot of brain development which happens, which is not seen in adult medicine. So, So I'm glad about my decision.
Right, right. So how do you manage your overcrowded patients in your clinic?
Yeah, well, it's a very demanding branch in medicine. Unlike many other branches, I'm sure in pediatrics, you know, a lot of the practice that we do is, you know, removing the patient's parents' fears, doubts. They have a lot of things that they hear from other people. Like they may hear that doing oil massage is very important.
Right, right.
They might want to give some medicines when the child is going to get teeth. So there are a lot of wrong practices in the community, and we have to very patiently listen to what the parents, the grandparents say, try to remove their, you know, wrong doubts and see that the child is given, the parents are given correct advice.
Mm-hmm.
There is another problem with our field is that the patient, particularly small children, they don't tell their own complaints.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to completely depend upon how accurate the parents or grandparents are telling the complaint.
Very true.
Suppose we ask the parents, ke kya takleef hai, and they say, ke, nahi, usko theek nahi lag raha hai. But when you ask them, theek nahi lag raha hai, mana kya ho raha hai? And then they say that, nahi, wo thoda shayad fever hai.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas an older person will come and tell the doctor, I have fever, I have this, I have my throat is paining,
right,
my stomach is paining. A 2-year-old child cannot say that my stomach is paining or may not be able to express.
Very true.
So our field is a little difficult because we have to depend on somebody else's history.
Mm-hmm.
On that, we have to make an assessment of the child's problem. But it's a good challenge, and I think we deal with an overcrowded practice because the good thing in, you know, medicine, which has happened, I think, in last 2-3 decades in cities like Mumbai, that a lot of people now preferably go to a pediatrician even for a minor complaint.
Mm-hmm.
And they don't go to a general practitioner.
Right.
I remember when I was a child, for a small problem, very often parents would take you know, children to a MBBS doctor who is not a specialist. But now the trend for last many years is that you go to a specialist.
True.
And that is one reason that pediatricians all over Mumbai and other parts of the country have become quite busy. It's quite a busy profession.
True. So what is the most important, interesting area, part of your job which you love very much?
Well, one is, I mean, interesting in the sense, actually, honestly, over a period of time, we see the same types of problems. So it becomes quite monotonous.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, the best part is that when children get all right from their problem, suppose it's a child with a very high fever, okay, 104 fever, and then he follows up and the fever is gone.
Mm.
A child who has a very bad chest congestion, cough, is having difficulty in breathing. So we are able to, you know, almost like we're not even near God, but something similar or close to that with our expertise, with our knowledge, we are able to treat people of their problems. And that is what makes our profession a noble profession, as it's called.
True.
So, and especially if we have a difficult case, a child who is not improving with some routine treatment, and we do something, we do some tests, or we examine the child, and we do something and the child improves. You know, I get a great kick out of that.
True.
Suppose I have thought of some diagnosis which, you know, somebody else has not thought of.
Mm-hmm.
Or if a child gets better with some ailment which is not improving easily, we get a great kick out of that.
Absolutely.
Yeah, so
what challenges are you facing, and if you feel that you are stuck somewhere, what is that thing where you think you are stuck and then you have to do something else?
Medical field is such that one is that knowledge itself needs to be upgraded. There are a lot of new studies which keep happening. It's our job as good doctors to be aware of the recent advances.
Mm-hmm.
So suppose I would get stuck sometimes if, you know, some child is not improving in a particular way. Suppose the child has a fever. You know, you start some standard medication, but the fever is not going. Several days have gone by. So we do face such challenges. In that case, we sometimes take an opinion from our colleagues. Like, I would refer the patient to some other pediatrician. Pediatrics is a branch which also has a lot of sub-specialities. That means you have somebody like a pediatric cardiologist, a neurologist, a nephrologist. So as a good pediatrician, I would know what my limits are. At a point where I feel that I may not be able to adequately treat a child, I would refer to some other person who is a super specialist or a subspecialist. And then I would discuss with that colleague of mine. And sometimes a healthy discussion between two colleagues helps to treat the patient in a better way.
Right. Okay. So how strong is your bonding with your patients, and how do you manage and how you socialize?
Well, I actually have been in this hospital for, I mean, it's going to be close to 16 years now.
Mm-hmm.
Before that, I used to work as a lecturer at Sion Hospital in Mumbai.
Okay.
I passed my MD in January 1999.
Mm-hmm.
That's a little over 20 years ago.
Right.
So for the first 4.5 years, I worked at Sion Hospital, and then I have been with Hira, with Dr. L.H. Hiranandani Hospital in Powai. So I spend approximately 12 hours in the hospital, sometimes even more. I even work for a few hours on Sunday, which some people find quite difficult to imagine, but
correct.
I am in a way a workaholic. Also, the branch of pediatrics, I have realized, your availability for a long period of time in the hospital, your being available to the patient when they come, is extremely important.
Mm.
You have to be competent. You have to know your job well. Your knowledge, your experience is extremely important. But your being available is even more important.
True.
Suppose there's a doctor who works for only 4 hours a day. He may be very, very good.
Mm.
But suppose when the patient comes there with, say, bleeding from the nose, or if the child has got hurt and the parents feel he's got a fracture, and you're not there in the hospital, you're not there in the clinic, the patient is bound to go to somebody else. You may be the best, but if you're not available. So availability for long hours and constant hard work is the key to being a good pediatrician.
Very true.
And the key to being successful.
Right.
So you have to put in a long, very long hours of work. So that obviously does impact your personal life.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I often feel I have almost no personal life,
right,
almost no time for myself.
Mm-hmm.
But you can't have everything. If you want to be good in your job, if you want to be well known, you want to dedicate enough time, then you have to dedicate that much time.
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. You very correctly said. My next question is regarding that only. How do you manage your family and work profession with this stressful job?
Yeah, so I think most pediatricians, when I speak to my colleagues, do spend a lot of time. It's up to me to reduce my work hours. But as I said, if I do that, I would not be able to be doing justice to my job. Mm-hmm. Because you have to be available. And in fact, even beyond our working hours, I have students under my guidance in this hospital who are doing their training in pediatrics.
Right.
So they are on duty in the night, and very often they call us up from the emergency to discuss a case which has come in the night.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a lot of hard work put in, which may not be apparent to a lot of non-medical people, in fact.
Yeah. So Dr. Ahuja, whom do you consider a successful doctor, according to you? Who would be the successful doctor?
Yeah, so successful doctor is someone who people have a lot of respect for. People want to see that doctor. They are willing to even wait for a long time for that doctor. Mm-hmm. They trust the treatment given by that doctor.
Right.
So he has sort of like what we say a good name or a good reputation. Obviously, a person who is doing well in his work would also be earning a good amount of money,
mm-hmm.
as is obviously required even for doctors, that we also have to run our household.
Absolutely.
So obviously, only earning money is not the only parameter for success, but someone who's doing well financially,
mm-hmm.
somebody who's also doing a lot of good work. I think every doctor should also do a little bit of charity. It's not for people who can afford treatment, but at least for the ones who are needy, who are not able to afford treatment, say in a private setup. I think if every doctor sees a few patients who are poor, or spends a few minutes, say for seeing a poor child who can't pay your fees, I think it gives us a lot of satisfaction, and many of us doctors do that.
Mm-hmm.
So having a good balance between the commercial part, the earning money, and being a good doctor with a clear conscience, giving treatment based on proper scientific guidelines,
mm-hmm.
not trying to fool or cheat patients. And when people in the community respect you,
true.
They value your treatment, I think that is what a successful doctor means.
Can you also share with us some unforgettable incidents which happened in past with you?
Yeah, there have been some unpleasant circumstances where we have had, you know, say when I was working in the intensive care unit,
mm-hmm.
where there have been deaths, you know, you have a family who've just lost a child. So those are things which do affect me, and they would upset us because the parents would be extremely upset.
Mm-hmm.
There are patients who don't show desirable improvement with whatever treatment is given.
Mm-hmm.
We have children who have a disease called cerebral palsy, or who have mental retardation. There are children who have autism. So some of these things bother me, or bother us doctors, that in spite of all the advances in medical field, there are many situations where we are not able to combat, or we can't fight death, or we can't fight certain diseases where we are not able to get the desirable outcome.
Mm-hmm.
So we are also helpless in certain ways.
Yeah.
But as a doctor, we always know that we must try our best. We can't achieve always 100% results. No one can. But at least our effort should be 100%.
Mm-hmm.
So there are cases where I have, had a death in the NICU, or, we sometimes feel that could we have done something else? Could we have maybe, retrospectively saved this child. So
right.
those thoughts do bother us sometimes.
Right.
Yes.
So every person has their mentor or some idol people whom they usually follow. So do you have any mentor in life?
Well, all throughout our studies, we have good teachers who we look upon. And my teachers from Wadia Children's Hospital, which I did my MD pediatrics training from. So I still remember them. I still sometimes ask them when I have difficulties. I have no particular mentor I could name, but I think most of the doctors, I look upon the hospital chief where I'm working right now. I really respect him because I think he is a great administrator, the way he has managed this hospital.
Mm-hmm.
So we definitely,
Right, right. So I'm sure you must be going through many challenges. Every day is a new day for you.
True.
So have you come across any specific biggest lesson which you have learned from your experience?
Yeah, I think a lot of patience is required.
Okay.
Sometimes when we are busy also, or we have a lot of things on our mind, there are so many things that we have to do. Like I may get a call to attend a delivery, at the same time I have a child in the ICU. We are human beings ultimately. So
right.
What I've realized over a period of time, that if you keep your cool and you maintain little patience, the result that we are able to give is better. So what I have learned over a period of a little over 20 years of practice now,
mm-hmm.
is that one has to be a little patient. One should listen to the patient who comes to us, their complaints, not be very hasty in giving some, you know, treatment advice.
Mm-hmm.
Listen to the other person.
Right.
Give some time to the other person. And I also have learned over a period of time that the way we explain how to give the medicines, going into small details,
mm-hmm.
of whether it is a syrup or a tablet, of how to give it, how many times a day, how to measure the syrup, small things like if the child vomits out the medicine, then what to do, when to come back, when not to come back. It's very important that the patient, the child's relatives know what to expect in the next few days.
Right.
Okay, so if I have a child who I have diagnosed, say, to have dengue fever, it is my job, I have learned over a period of time, to explain to them. So how much the patient is able to understand,
mm-hmm.
and follow our instructions is also important.
Right.
Just giving the instructions, but we are not sure ke un log ne samjha ke nahi, wo log waise carry out karenge ke nahi, then we have not done our job properly.
Absolutely.
So the end user, the patient, should understand and should get all right and should know when to come, when not to come.
Mm-hmm.
It is our job as pediatricians to explain what are the red flags, when they should come back immediately to the hospital.
Right. Right.
A common problem that we face a lot, particularly I think as pediatricians, is a lot of patients asking telephonic advice.
Mm-hmm.
So they would call up on our personal number or the hospital number and say, okay, this is the complaint, give us some advice. We do try our best to mm-hmm. help them, but there is a limitation to how much it can do,
absolutely.
And it's dangerous.
Absolutely.
Because somebody says, my child is having breathing difficulty.
Mm-hmm.
It could be just a nose block. It could be so severe that the child may need hospitalization.
Absolutely.
So that is again a challenge that I face in my everyday practice on how to manage people over the phone. And people tend to also ask, you know, queries over a WhatsApp message, which
mm-hmm.
is actually, in a way, if I'm not wrong, even legally not correct.
Mm-hmm.
So by the court law, we are not permitted actually to give advice over a message or a phone. But there are sometimes genuine, you know, the patient is far away and they trust you, they ask you on the phone. To some extent, we can give some advice, but it's a great challenge on where to draw the line.
Correct.
And when to insist that the patient must,
mm-hmm.
you know, visit a doctor.
So every person has success and failures, and failures are the keys to move on.
Correct.
So I'm sure you must have gone some failures, and
yes.
So how did you connected those to success?
Correct. So there are ups and downs in our life. Like there are days when I'm very busy. There are days when I have very few patients. There are times when I find my own patients not following up with me, going to other doctors,
mm-hmm.
which makes me feel that maybe they don't trust my treatment or my...
Right. Right.
They are not happy with me for some reason. So then it's a constant, you know, we would try to improvise ourselves,
right.
so that we are able to do our job to the fullest.
Right.
But I think that happens in every profession.
Correct.
And, you know, it is difficult to satisfy everyone.
Right.
Yeah. So medical field, doctor's profession also is becoming, unfortunately, in a way, people are perceiving it more like, you know, like as if they are almost buying an object.
Mm-hmm.
So one of the reasons, as I said, I became a doctor is almost everyone in my family is a doctor. So what I have learned from my parents is the kind of respect that doctors used to get. So one reason I became a medical person
yeah.
is, you know, because you are looked upon as someone higher up in society compared
mm-hmm.
to someone else. But
Absolutely.
Today, a lot of people feel, doctor hi to hai na, kya ho gaya? I mean,
mm-hmm.
so we are almost, I feel, a little, you know, discouraged and unhappy by the way people have started perceiving us.
Very true.
There is, like they say, black sheep in every,
mm-hmm.
you know, group. So there are maybe some doctors who are, you know, not doing their job with a clear conscience. And those few people, there are, you know, bad people and good people in every field, may have, you know, spoiled the name of the profession to some extent.
Mm-hmm.
And that causes these failures. So
right.
sometimes these failures are because of people not having that much faith or trust,
mm-hmm.
tend to doing doctor shopping very easily. So that sometimes is, I would take it as a failure.
Right, right.
But then it's my job to try to improvise.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely.
So that we are back on the path of success.
Absolutely, absolutely. So as I said earlier, every day is a new day. So when you get up in the morning, what motivates you to...
Well, it is actually, I think in all our jobs, we are kind of tuned that we have to go to our workplace and work. Honestly, 20 years of practice, I'm a person who's actually hardly taken any leaves. I was just since I joined this hospital. I have taken leave just for 4 days in 15 and a half years. So, but still the motivation is that I have to do my job as a doctor. Unlike many other professions, the job has a lot of responsibility. I owe a lot of responsibility to what I do.
True.
So it's not that, you know, kaam chala gaya nahi bataya. So for example, just last night, I got 4 phone calls between 12 midnight to 5 a.m. Okay, by my resident doctor, my assistant from the emergency, to ask me about some patients who had come to the emergency, to the casualty. Each and every time I had to listen and I patiently answered whatever was to be done. And all the treatment was given to the patient correctly. Now, in almost no other profession, you are woken up and spoken to at 1 a.m. and 4 a.m. And you have to keep your mind clear and you have to answer. But as a doctor, I know that I have to do it because it is my responsibility. I'm not doing somebody a favor. It's my job. I took up this profession because it's my job. But it, so that challenge is there, but to constantly do good work.
So as a doctor, as you said in the last question, like, what do you think, what would be your contribution to the community and how you can contribute?
Yeah, see, I think community, particularly my field being pediatrics, when we see that, you know, the children's health is good, these are the children who are going to grow up into healthy adults. So if I can do a, you know, proper advice to the community on nutrition, on how, what food to eat, what milk the child should get, which vitamins, which tonics should be given. I see to it that all the children in the community get all the essential vaccinations. When they get all vaccines, the chance they catch infections is less. So guidance to the parents, to the community, as I said, if it's possible, a little bit of charity work, even for the people who can't afford expensive medical treatment. I can do good work for the community apart from individual patients. So these children would grow up into healthy and good adults and human beings.
So I'm sure everyone has gone through their success and failures in life. They have a lot of achievements. I'm sure you must have achieved a couple of things, good things. Would you like to share some achievements of yours?
Well, I, in the hospital that I work for, I have received a recognition award last year, which is called the CARE Award. I have been actually the only doctor from this hospital ever since it was built who's got that award by the hospital management. So I think that was a great achievement. So it was like a recognition for the hard work that you have put in, and for the perseverance. And I think the best, you know, reward that I think I feel is when patients are happy with me. So when the parents come and tell me that, you know, doctor, aapne dekha ek bar, aapka haath laga, to hume lagta hai abhi bachcha theek ho jayega. So that is the best reward. Okay, so when I am busy, I have a lot of work, I'm able to do my work properly and I'm able to do it constantly. I think that that itself is a big reward. When people are getting all right with your treatment, you're trying to do your best and, you know, and it's a constant process. So I've realized that it's very difficult to reach on to some level, to achieve some success, to have a reputation in the community. But it's even more difficult to stay there because there are a lot of people, like in every profession, who are wanting to pull you down. There is competition in every field. There are people who would like to put you down, who would criticize you. And you have to bear all that and still continue doing good work.
So, sir, my last question is, what is the most important piece of advice as a pediatrician you would like to give to others?
Well, I think people should have faith in doctors. I still believe that amongst all people, all professions, the number of dishonest people among doctors is still relatively less. Okay, so if you see any profession, I don't want to name any, but comparatively, we are still a better lot of people. We have to really study a lot and struggle a lot in the best young years of our life to become a doctor. And then we keep working very hard. I would like to tell the community that you must trust doctors more. We are not as bad as maybe you all think. I would be really happy if the general community starts trusting doctors as they used to. I think it's every doctor's responsibility to be honest towards his patients. I think even if you have a clear conscience, you do your work as absolutely as per scientific guidelines. You don't try to commercialize yourself. You can still earn a good amount of money. So a doctor, I would like to give this message to all my juniors, to people who are pursuing a career in medicine and pediatrics, that have a little compassion for your patients. Think of them that, if this was your own family member, how would you treat them?
Right.
Never just take it as any other profession. You have to have that, you know, that love and affection for the job. If you feel you are not tuned for it, do something else. It is a profession which requires a balance of commerce, art and science. So it's like you need all the three to be a good doctor.
Right.
And please don't let your own needs and everything take a upper seat over your actual basic job. So you have to do your responsibility properly. You must be honest towards your patients and you must keep upgrading yourself. As doctors, we must keep knowing what is happening in the medical field.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Never hesitate to take opinion of your colleagues. If you feel you are not able to treat someone, I would give this message to all my colleagues also. Take a second opinion. Discuss the problem with someone else.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And have a healthy discussion. Don't be worried that your patient will go away to someone else.
Mm-hmm.
If they want to, they will anyway.
Right.
It's not that you can hold back people.
Mm-hmm.
You do your job properly and then leave it to other things.
Right.
And the community, I would want them to have, I think, a little back faith to consider doctors to be a noble profession as it always has been.
Right, right. So thank you, Dr. Ahuja. Thank you for taking time and wish you all the very best.
Yeah.
We are very glad to have you on the Professional Times.
Thank you.